Hello and welcome. If this is your first time here, my name is Anna. I am the owner and creator of Gemstorm Relevation. Here we like to talk about all things moon, all things Reiki, crystals, energy, all the really great stuff. So come on in and listen up. Today we're going to be talking about the next full moon that's coming up on November 30th, which is called the Beaver Full Moon, and it is coming in with the sign of Gemini. So what does that mean? We're going to talk a little bit briefly about it. I'm not going to get too into detail. You can look up all the information on the blog, but I'm going to give you some bonus content here that's not on the blog that I thought was really interesting that I wanted to share with you guys as well. So first off, so the full Beaver Moon is coming at 4:32 Eastern, and that number alone is really incredible. So for anybody that isn't aware, we have these number sequences that have that hold specific meanings, right? And the number 432 can be looked at in a couple of different ways. So I personally am a big fan of, I'm a really big fan of sound therapy and like listening to different frequencies to help raise your vibration. And 432 is like the ultimate healer frequency. So that's just letting you know that this energy is really coming in, looking for healing and looking for change and looking to bring really the best possible outcome that you can have in your life. So let's see, just to give you a definition of what like music therapy is. So music therapy is evidence-based clinical use of musical interventions to improve the quality of life. And that's by Wikipedia, that's their definition. So this music is used to raise your vibration. So what happens is when we get stuck in certain energies, like if we're stuck in anger, we're stuck in sadness, we're stuck in depression, those are considered low vibe energies that are at the bottom of the vibrational scale. And as we work through any of our emotions, past traumas, things like that, our vibration begins to lift. So by listening to frequency music, it kind of takes out that middleman, but it is still going to bring things to your awareness that need to be healed, but it's just going to help bring your system up into a new vibration. And whatever it is that you're vibrating out into the universe is what you're bringing back in. So when you're in low vibe, then that's what low vibe is coming back. So if you are stuck in sadness or anger, more of that is coming to you. So the best thing you can do is put on some frequency music for whatever issue you're dealing with so that it can lift you and raise you out of that. Okay. And then also on a second note, I just wanted to talk to you about angel numbers. So angel numbers are typically like a sequence of numbers that you're consistently seeing. This can be 111, 222, etc. But we can look at them in different ways too. So if there's other numbers that you're seeing all of the time together, so if it's like say 515, 818, 101, and even in this case in the 432, I wanted to look up to see what that angel number meant in regards to the full moon to see really what it's about. And I thought it was really, really interesting. So the definition or the thought for what angel number 432 represents is brings your destiny closer, but your guides will never mess with your karma. So be mindful of your actions and pay special attention to your honesty. Now that correlates perfectly with this full moon because this energy is really asking you to get honest with yourself, honest with your feelings, honest with people if you haven't been, and just really digging into that energy. So let's look a little more into what the energy of a full moon is in general. So the energy of a full moon in general is all about gratitude and forgiveness. We've done the work through the new moon to bring in our manifestations, to set our intentions out into the universe. And now is the time that we're sowing those seeds, but we're also showing gratitude to the universe for anything that we may have learned along the way. If our direction got changed, it most likely was for the best. And then just kind of recalibrating, being grateful and giving yourself and maybe others forgiveness if it's needed. So that's the focus that you should have with every full moon. But this full moon in particular is called the Beaver Moon. So the reason that it's called the Beaver Moon is because our ancestors or Aboriginals however you want to look at it, this would be the time that they would be preparing for winter. So you can look at it in two different ways. This would be the last opportunity that they would have to set traps for beavers so that they could collect furs and skins to help keep them warm during the winter months. Or you can also look at it from the spirit animal of the beaver. The spirit animal of the beaver is all about getting prepared, being organized, getting things ready for the season that's coming ahead of them, because you need to have food, you need to have shelter, you need to get prepared for all of those things during this time, because winter solstice is just around the corner and things are not going to be as readily available for you, for them, right? So this moon does really resonate with the energy of change and taking action. And to be able to do that, we need to get really honest about how we're feeling about the way things are going in our life, the things that are working, the things that are not working, and what we can do to improve it. So that's your change and that's your action. It's a really good time to nurture any emotions that you have. So it is time to express and let those things go, but not to dig too deep into it. So just let that surface level of sadness and anger, etc., be there and sort through it. Thank it for being there and just ask yourself, like, if any of this energy is ready to go, can you please leave my system now? Because I do not feel like you are serving my highest good at this time. And anything that's ready to go will be leaving you. So now what is the Gemini energy going to bring in? So here's the thing about the full moons is that, yes, we are in Sagittarius season. I'm a Sagittarius. But when we're looking at the full moon, it's always the opposing sign of what the energy is bringing in. So this is the sign of Gemini. Gemini is the exact opposite across the wheel of Sagittarius. So this, again, really does encourage change, okay? So just remain positive and allow these changes to come in. And if you do it with a positive attitude, then it's going to be positive changes. But if we do it with a negative attitude, then there's a good chance that we're just going to keep attracting what it is that we don't want. Kind of like what I mentioned with the frequency stuff. If we're stuck in a certain frequency, then that's what we're going to continuously bring back in. And it's kind of the same rule of thumb with this as well. So in the blog, there is a list of questions for you to journal about and ask yourself. So I highly recommend you go and check that out. This is a really big energy. This is a great opportunity to really reflect and think about the things that you want to do differently in your life, the things that you would like to see different in your life. And I know that for a lot of us right now, it feels like there's not a whole lot we can do. It feels like we're stuck in certain places or that we're so restricted that we can't do things. But that doesn't mean that we can't go in the inside and look at the changes that need to be brought in from within. Because whenever we are able to change those things from within, it ripples out and it starts to change just how we are, how we're putting ourselves out there. It changes our vibration so that we can bring better things in, right? So I highly recommend you go check out the blog. In there, I've got the ritual so that you know what to do. It gives you a step-by-step guide on what you can do. It gives you an explanation on how to do your moon water. And then I also have recommendations for crystals that can support you. So if you are looking for some crystals, please do reach out. I have a pretty big stock. I got some things up on Etsy. All of those links will be for you below in the description. If you've liked this video and you like everything that Gemstorm Relevation represents, please do make sure that you hit the subscribe button. Then you'll get notified anytime there is a new upload. I'm typically here for every new moon and full moon at least, and sometimes I get in some other content for you as well. So thank you so much for being here. Have a great day. Namaste.